Bad weather continues to hamper search and retrieval operations for the six remaining missing passengers from the capsized motorbangka in Iloilo Strait. A helicopter from the Philippine Air Force surveyed the Iloilo Strait, while the Philippine Coast Guard used a tugboat.
Remember, the six missing doesn't mean that all of them are at sea, at water pa, kasi pwedeng na wash out na sa mga coast, sa shoreline. It could even, they could possibly be washed up to Negros Occidental. Yung iba baka daw nasa bahay na rin, hindi lang nagre-report. And that's a possibility.
There is a separate investigation conducted by the Maritime Casualty Investigator at the maritime industry regarding the incident. Based on the initial investigation, there was no problem with the vessels as these capsized due to a squall. The Philippine Coast Guard, for its part, says there was no weather disturbance before the incident, so vessels were not prevented from leaving the area.
Walang prohibition. Walang. Ang regulasyon ng Coast Guard, pagka public storm warning signal number 1 nakahoy sa isang area, doon lang natin di pinapayagan lahat ng klase ng sasakyang pandagat.
The MV Kazia, the first motorbangka to set sail to Guimaras, was the first that capsized, but its crew survived. MB Chichi followed in the afternoon. Several motorbangkas set sail from Guimaras to Iloilo, where the MB Jenny Vince capsized. The Coast Guard Iloilo wondered too if who allowed them to sail.
The weather condition then during departures, the departure were clear. No, it's not prohibited under the protocol.
They are also investigating why several passengers were not included in the manifest. Insurance claims are now being prepared, but only those who have written in the passenger manifest can claim. Boat trips to Guimaras are still cancelled. Passengers are using ro-ro vessels to travel. The Marino Party List is pushing for an investigation on the tragedy. It is formulating the Maritime Modernization Bill, which aims to solve problems faced by the maritime industry in the country. Malacañang expressed its sympathy to the victims of the tragedy. It has already advised all agencies to extend help to the victims of the tragedy. One survivor recalled how he clung on the hull of the vessel as waves and rains hammered their bodies. Al Salazar was on his way home in Guimaras on board MB Chichi.
Kalmado pang dagat, tapos na ang ulan.
He said the sea was calm at first, but then it suddenly rained hard with strong winds. Al said he was trapped inside the motorbangka, but he tried to swim for safety outside of the capsized vessel. He also said they have life jackets, but most passengers did not wear it. While he was on top, he could hear the others asking for help under the capsized boat. But he was not able to do anything for fear that he too might drown. Rosil Garcia, another survivor, said it was the Philippine Coast Guard who allowed them to travel, even if there was an initial suspension of the trips due to the capsizing of the first two boats.